the grad student from Springfield, Ohio, who is now the current leading scorer on this squad.
I think being a Fordham basketball player means having the right attitude, just bringing it that right attitude, that right mindset every day, and just playing until you can't play anymore.
Quisenberry knocks it down.
Darius Quisenberry with room from the near side.
Quisenberry hits it over Burton.
If I have the right attitude and I bring it every day, the person next to me, my teammate, if they don't have it and they see me bring it in, they're like, all right, well, I can pick up my energy since DQ's bringing it. And then when we step off the court, just being the right man off the court, always treating people well with respect, that carries on to life after basketball as well. If you have a good attitude in life, you're most likely going to be successful.
At night.
I think we know we have to play hard. I think coaches instilled that in us from day one, summer session one. That was the first thing we worked on, diving on the floor, taking charges, sprinting back on defense, run off screens hard, set screens hard and stuff like that. Just playing with everything we got. If you get tired, hold up a fist, somebody will come give you a sub. We have an undying sense of fight. Like, we will never say quit until that last buzzer sounds.
Anybody who graduates college while being a student athlete in 3 years, obviously they're driven to be really successful.
I graduated in 3 years from Youngstown State, so getting my sport broadcasting degree over there and then coming to New York, the opportunities were kind of endless on the school side and the basketball side.
I just love being around a game of basketball. I think that's pretty much why I got my degree in sports broadcasting. And I just want to stay around the game after I'm done playing it professionally and stuff like that. I mean, the competitiveness, you can still be around it even if you're a play-by-play guy. You can still be competitive in that aspect. Just calling games and just the atmosphere of it is tremendous. 3, 2 steps back, bang. Got to keep a hand up on that kid. Shovel pass to Chuba, slam dunk for O'Hams. No look, I've never seen Rose do that.
I don't think there's a team in this conference that we can't beat. Once you click off the court, it's automatically going to click on the court because you don't care who scores or who gets what recognition and stuff like that. You're just genuinely happy to be with your brothers. And we just want to win. Everybody wants the same goal. Seriously, you can tell there's like a higher standard here. Early is on time is late. My father definitely instilled it in me as a young child. He used to wake us up, me, my brother, and my sister, at like 4:30 in the morning, go work out before school and stuff like that. In high school, he coached me, AAU, he coached me a couple years, so he's always been that coach in my life, but he's done a really good job of being separating coach and father. Actually, playing for Coach Neptune is my first time playing for a black head coach, other than my father. That's a big deal for me, and this is the first time actually having a majority black coaching staff for me. It's huge just to build those bonds and then learn from other older black men and stuff like that, just to keep building the culture and then also learning the culture as well. You're coming into a program that obviously in the past hasn't been the best and doesn't have the best track record. So you have to bring a new type of energy to a program to change it. I think he brought that energy into New York, this being his first year as a head coach. I think he brings it every day at practice too as well. In games, you see him jumping on the sideline and stuff like that. I think he does a great job of that, just bringing energy every day and just bringing that glass half full mentality.
I like the way Kyle Neptune described Darius Quisenberry to us. I said, when you see Quisenberry, what does he mean for your program? He said he's a nasty competitor.
I think he's been on me the hardest, one about catching and shooting, just getting that into my game, trying to change my role a little bit because my role changed when I came here. I was more of an on-ball guard at Youngstown State, and then when I came here, I kind of played more off-ball at the two guard. Just developing that catch and shoot mentality. I had the mindset of a scorer, but not to that point where they wanted me to be. But also just about being a leader through and through, just being that steady medium throughout the game, and that person that everybody can look at and know that I'm rock solid no matter what. My facing is going to change. I always talk about being a steely-eyed assassin. My relationship that I built with Coach Neptune and Coach Ergo over the recruiting process while I was in the transfer portal, them expressing to me the things that they have in mind for me as a man and also as a basketball player.
You care about them as a human being. You spend time off the court. They're more apt to listen to what you're explaining to them on the court. Darius has done that at a very high level, and he's continued to grow as a human being just as much as he has as a player, and you're starting to see that come to fruition.
Three-pointer, Darius!